So, hello everybody. Let's solve Advent of Code day 23. So, I have copied the template. Day 23. Let's start the watcher and let's see. So day 18, set register multiply. If you run the program, how many times is the multiply instruction invoked? Okay. So, list instruction, so how does it look? It can be register or content, but in these other cases it's on a register multiply. Jump at 0. Okay, so string lines, list mappers, instruction, parse content. So this could be okay. So we have dictionary and is dictionary from string to integer. So input is run instructions, starting CPU, So they all start at zero, and starting CPU position, starting position is zero. So run list instruction CPU position, and if so, if position so let's do array, I guess. So oops, parse so array, and now case so so new CPU, new position will be okay, so if X is not zero, contents integer. To integer. Wait, no. string to integer. Does it do result or maybe result? So, okay, integer or so. Okay, so new CPU. So if it's like this, we only jump. If it's anything else, we jump. Why? Okay, so now new CPU. CPU stays the same here. Here, the dictionary get X. Okay, so set, we don't do this, but we will do it in super multiply. So CPU insert X this. So minus. That could be it. So register. Register string was wrong. What? Yeah, maybe it's because of this. Well, it's not. Run instructions, array. CPU. We are missing something. So, maybe value, another value insert. All right, so like this. Probably. Oops. I don't number, man. So CPU. Starting CPU is CPU. Why does it think I am using it as number? Oh, this is first. And then insert x well. Okay, so this works. Oh, I know what's wrong. Okay, test passed. So, okay, that's done. Register A starts at 1. Okay. Coprocessor's ultimate goal is to determine final value in H. So, like, should I? Should I even try to run it? Counter. So nothing adds into CPU. Okay, CPU counter. So let's run it, and in the meantime, what? Output to. That's not right, right? So oh, right. Okay. So, let's see the code. And let's. I don't have anything to write with them. Okay. So. So, if A is not 0, jump to. Okay, so this is. Jump 082. Okay. So V is 81, C is 81. C equals B. So yeah, I did, and I'm kind of hoping the program finishes before I figure it out on my own. So I'm not sure if like I'm supposed to like do some optimization of program that's of the interpreter, or if I'm just supposed to like do it in my head. But I am obviously doing it in my head. So F is 1, D is 2, E is 2, G is also 2, so okay, let's write like this. No, let's keep it. So C is B. So multiply gem not zero if G so okay, G is not 0. Where am I? So if G is not 0, jump minus 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, G equals D. So the I lost myself in thoughts, mainly about the battery. I will have to keep an eye on that. GSD. Wait. Oh, right. Okay, that makes sense. So. G is not 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3. E equals 2. E equals 2. Okay, so I think we can try to do what this does is I'm suddenly not so sure. Wait. A jump, not zero, so I'm getting lost in this. I think I'll go for the charger and some pen to write with. Okay, so let's see again. V equals 81. B if A is not 0. Hello. If A is not 0. Jump plus 2. So if 1 is not 0, jump 5, so B. Yeah, so I don't know if I'm getting out of memory, but probably not, probably it's just a while loop, but it doesn't seem like it wants to end anytime soon. So B times 100. So okay, right now I can do this. B minus right 100 5000. C is B. C. That's 17,000. D equals 2. E equals 2. G equals D. Okay, so now I can this jump 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it goes to F equals 1. So GD multiplied by E minus B gem not 0 G2 if G is not 0 jump 2 F equals 0 E plus 1 so where am I? G is E. So if G is not 0, jump minus 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. G equals D. D. G is D. G minus B. If G is not 0, jump minus 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 7, 2. Right. if F is not 0, jump plus 2. H plus 1, G equals B. G C if G is not 0, jump 2 and if 2 jump 3, which is the end. And okay, so this one's two jumps of B plus 17, and two jumps somewhere. So this goes here, and if two goes minus 23. So 8 F equals 1. So this now looks like this. Ah, okay. So I have some kind of jumps. Let's see if I can somehow optimize it. This means so C equals B. Go to A. Well, not assembly to C, but basically we have some kind of assembly, which if you let it run, it just runs and runs and runs and never outputs. Like I am waiting for output to here. And so we need to know what is in H after it ends. So I'm just kind of looking at the code and seeing what it does, trying to, I don't know, find a formula for some kind of loop, find out what it does, get the answer myself, never have to run it. So stuff like that. You don't use debugger. Well, I don't see. Well, this is not like. This is fictional assembly, fictional machine code. So there's no tooling for it. I have created interpreter. I could print out things at various like positions. This I could do. So A is B is this one. How is my progress? Well, I am now just I have it written on a paper. I'm not sure if you can see. And so I'm trying. And so I'm trying to like unroll it, fix find some nice way to write it. And I have no idea right now what it does. Not it. So, V is this. So, C. So go to E, else. So if G equals 1, F is 0, right? G is not 0, go to D. Minus B. Go to C. Oh, so if F equals 0, H plus 1, G is B minus C. If G equals 0 and go to B. So okay, so let's put the program to some use and let's run. If position, no, if breakpoints. So, what I'm interested in is four, eight, ten, 11. All right, I did annual this. So, let's see. What is H plus 1? 25. So maybe not these just yet. This one is important. F. If G is 0, F equals 0. F. So 15. So G is 0. Right. So in the 15, we should be able to see how are the values in the registers moving. So if breakpoints list member position, then else, okay, so what do the values look like they're doing? So, is it finding factors? It dividing? It seems E equals B divided by D. I'm not sure how D grows. Okay, so at this point, I think, yeah. So it finds factors. The question is, what happens afterwards? So, can we say at point 15? F equals 0. So this is probably where do we Right, so where do we set E? E equals B divided by D. You know what? Let's keep this in another buffer. Let's not lose it. So, let's. And what does G end with? G is 0. Oops, did not want to do that. So we are basically trying different D's. We are trying different D's. What was D? G equals D. And so H so somehow the C will have to change until they meet. C is B plus. So how do we change C? So I think this can go. This is always true. So they didn't meet yet, but okay, let's run it. Let's run it from 15 with let's run it from 15 with CPU where B is this, C is this. So, okay, it's time from Wolfram Alpha. Okay, so I'm not sure whether what happens if D is greater than E, so three, four, five, let's say. How does E change? Shouldn't E move down? Okay, so three, okay, so square root, right? Three to eight. I'm not sure what to set the E to. Okay, let's do another thing. Let's start. Let's keep where we were. But let's debug different points. So breakpoints 15, sure, 25, sure, but let's debug at D plus 1, so 16 and 20. And what happens if not even sure what C has to do with it? B minus C, that never happens, right? C never gets. So I'm not sure. So does B change? B minus 17. Okay, B plus 17. So if G If G is not zero, wow. So C okay, let's say G is zero. If F is zero. Okay, so is it the number of numbers between the right answer, but 999 could be it. So I will have to wait, right? Wait a minute. Okay. If G is not 0, okay, so what I don't know is how the numbers jump. So I need to know at point 14, at point 14, I need to know how did G change. So let's say, so G equals D. G equals D. Okay, so 12 and 14 is what interests me. Okay, so okay, now here's the run. So, am I only interested in 12 if something is 0, G is 0. G equals D. So okay, so I think I got it into a loop. When does it end? Does it end when B equals E? Further, right? No! Damn it! Stop! I should have put this into Vim buffer. Damn it. Okay, so when E goes like this, then D goes there. So G is D. Okay, so G is B minus C. Well, wait, we didn't get here even, right? G is D minus B. And I want D minus B. D minus B is 0. Sorry for the mic. D minus B is 0. D plus 1. So that means we have tried all D's until B is happens when d is 108, 100, which means we tried all of these, all of the numbers one by one. That's crazy. So when does h end? When does it increase? So f equals 0, g is 0, f equals 0, and f equals 0, only when g minus b, g times e minus b equals 0, and g times e equals 0. Wait, what? Doesn't make much sense to me. G times so if g is not 0. Okay, so if until g equals b, right? That's what it says. So after we have done all of the divisors of 108, then we do if b equals c and okay, so otherwise, do it all again. I think that's what it says. So the right answer. So what's the condition for F? See it again. If f equals 0, when does f not equal 0? So f is 1 and g times e minus b is 0, f is 0. So e g times e minus b. So it's like the number of times when, like number of squares. You know, like if, you know, I'm not sure what. So if it finds d and e that are the same, it does do one. think this will be easier in Python. Oops. So, if so, okay, so for B C seven step, print print current. Do we still are we still running? I hope not. PyPy does it? Okay, it probably does start there. So if if a square okay. Come on, I can write. So, return an so known numbers like it there. Okay, so that's probably a bad hunch. Okay, so that doesn't happen. Okay, tried it anyway. Okay, so okay, so G times E minus B is 0. So let's so if CPU get D no yeah if okay, let's say we got to like D equals B. Go to C. Okay, so we were Where were we printing? It was here, right? 15 or 16? I'm not sure. So, B is constant, C is constant, let's say D equals B. How did E change? So E just grows, so let's say it's 108 too. Now F is 0, G is 0, H is 0. So let's try to simulate it. So okay, so F is G 0, and we should be where should we be? So F is 0 only when we have a pair, then E grows, times E is B that we know. D times E minus B is okay. D times E is B. Great. F is 0. Now E plus 1. So G is minus B, so minus B minus B what? G okay, so D times E is B, F is 0. Now G, which was 0, okay, so if it's not, then it, okay, so F stays 0. So we are after we found, after we found the pair, like divisors, then something has to happen. So like twice the divisor. So D, I can't see why. Yeah, probably. I probably messed it up. So G, okay, multiply. Yeah, sure. times E minus B E plus 1 G is all right. So okay, that suddenly makes more sense. So both D and E So E minus B, E plus 1 is B, right? And now D plus 1 is also B. So after we found a divisor, but I can't see how this can be true. E times, are we multiplying somewhere? So, okay, the first time it won't be true, but we have found a divisor. Now, if G is not 0, go here. Okay, so we go. D times E D times E minus B, okay. So in this second round, this doesn't interest us, and we are basically going E equals B, right? This is a loop until E equals B. So then we jump here and we loop until to work. So we are trying to find a value of B. We are trying to find a value of b for which something is true, like d plus 1 and b plus 1 is the number. Doesn't make much sense to me. Okay, so let's try here, and let's go from from 11. Okay, and let's put it through a less. So wait, what? Did it not go through? Okay, so yeah, sure, that was me. So let's find, here we are. So I want to see the B change, but it obviously doesn't. Do we somewhere you only check against the B? So okay, so let's try with one less. And let's try to do it like this. Okay, so we ran all the way through, and now it's 117, and we continue, right? So how come? Okay, let's try to find like the end of that loop. So we have it free. No, I'm just guessing. Sorry. No, I'm just guessing, but the H should be 999. But I'm not so sure anymore. So, right. So it goes once more. So, so what happens here? One thousand and one, but didn't it tell me it's too many? I think it did before. So so hello, kid. So how does the age change? So, when does F get set to 1? F does get set to 1 after B changes. So it, okay, so is it possible there are numbers that don't have any like prime, are there primes? Cat.
What? What? Wait.
Sure they can. So, Okay. Right. So, we want to find number of non-primes. Okay, so let's find the primes first, whether they are there or not. So, C now is prime. So H is, I don't know, 1000 or 1000 minus 1, whatever. So primes h minus primes minus 1, h minus primes plus 1. Who knows? So okay, so does it even run? Okay, so I seem to have found a weird is prime function. Come on. So, 92 primes. Wait, what was wrong? Print. Oh right, there's print here. So 92 primes. Nine. So let's try 908. Not the right answer. Please wait 5 more minutes. Well, we have enough time in the world. So let's try to get some intuition about the. Whether it's plus one or minus one. So, we start at zero. Okay, so, B is H is zero. It's like this, and H is one. So after B is H is 1000 And now how does it end? H1001. So it should probably be 909. I think. Three minutes. Eric, I know, no beyond doubt you're evil. Like, this is really some next level stuff. Oh. 19 minutes. How can you not be evil? How was it called? It was Sinacor or something? Yeah, Sinacor, right. Well, I have only seen it. I don't think I did much of it. Like, I think I downloaded the first thing and I didn't do much about it. But I don't remember if it was hard or if I just didn't even read the description. I don't know. Okay, I will take a look at it. I don't know, on Christmas. Okay, you have persuaded me. So 1 minute left. I think that won't be a morning stream. I think that will be late evening. So, this is probably the first one that has more people not having done. I can't speak English today. More people that didn't do the part two. Please, 20 seconds. I'm honestly not sure what will I do if it's not correct. That would be evil. Yes! We did it! So, I'm really glad. Oops. I hope the cat didn't turn off the mic. I'm really glad we did it. Cat definitely helped. And I am really not looking forward to tomorrow because it will probably be hard as hell. But I look forward to day 25 because from the last years it seems it's always easy. Okay, so thanks everybody for help. Zai Yang, I hope I'm not butchering up your name. Thanks a lot for like your clothes. It helped me a lot. So, yeah, thanks everybody, and see you tomorrow.